Hi guys, today we will discuss on SQL keys, which is a very important topic for the BI as a whole. So let's start with it. In today's video we will look at the important keys in our database. Like, we have primary key, candidate key, super key, composite key, surrogate key, alternate key, and the foreign key. So these are the main important keys which generally everybody should know about. It there are others as well, but that is a little bit least important. The first and foremost is the primary key. So as we all know that, you know, primary key is an attribute or set of attribute. You can say column as well as set of columns that can uniquely identify records in a table. So I have taken an example of an employee table where we have a column as employee ID, name, passport number, and Aadhaar number. So by looking at this table, we can say that employee ID can be one of the probable candidate for the primary key. Even passport number and Aadhaar number is also unique. That can be also made a primary key. But we have to think what will be the most suitable for the primary key, which will help us in future in joining with other tables, as well as having data type or the data which is sorted in size. Passport number is generally 8 to 10 digits, but employee ID can be like 1, 2, 3, 4, or maybe maximum 4 to 5 digits. So that will basically help us in a quicker join. So yeah, that's about primary key. Let's move on to the next, candidate key. So candidate key is also nothing but, as I think, the attribute and the set of attributes that can uniquely identify tuples in a table. Other than primary key, if I made something as a primary key, then that will not be qualified in the candidate key. So here we can use passport number or as a separate, which will be act as a candidate key, or we can combine passport number and Aadhaar number as a candidate key. So candidate key is nothing but the probable candidate for the primary key. So this is something which is there, but we generally don't have to mention it in our any database logic or while creating a table. So this is just for a kind of logical key which we keep in to understand the database better. Okay, moving on to the next, super key. The super key is also nothing but a multiple set of multiple keys that can uniquely identify your records or tuples. We call tuples for a record in table. Also, super key is nothing but a superset of a candidate key. So here I think we are trying to list out the combination of different columns which can be act as a uniquely identifying fields for a row. So yeah, let's move to the next topic, which is composite key. So this is nothing but a primary key or a candidate key which is combined to create a new column. It's not new column, basically, which can be combinedly used as a key for joining with the various tables. Next one is surrogate or artificial key. So by name itself, it's saying that it's an artificial key or a derived key which can be created using one or more columns of an table. This helps us to do a quick join and reducing index spacing. For example, in a sales table, we have a product ID and color ID, which we might need to join in future, join in basically for deriving or finding out the color of a product. This works well if we create a composite key. Then also it will work well, but it will take more indexing space and also create a longer joining. So what we will do, basically, we will simply combine these two fields into one and give some unique identifier so that we have to join only one column, which will improve the performance. Moving on to the next topic, which is alternate key. So it is nothing but the candidate key minus primary key. So for example, if we have a candidate key called employee ID and passport number, and in the previous example we say that we already made employee ID as a primary key, so the alternate key would be our passport number. Next one is foreign key. I think this is the easiest one. So we have a column in our lookup table or master table, which is identified as a primary key and which is kind of referencing to the employee or the fact table. So hence here department ID in the department table is called as foreign key. So thank you, and that's all for today's class lessons.